Historical Society, and our first Tuesday night of meetings in the fall of 2011. And I want to thank all you Irish lovers here, and there are other programs being on tonight concerning Stephen King and Angus King, but the Irish have no love for kings, especially English kings. So we're here to celebrate the Irish, and I'm going to turn it over to Annette. She's going to introduce Sept, says a few words as such, and she's going to introduce the speaker tonight. Thank you very much.
Maybe we should shut the music off and get here.
Okay, let's
see. Thank you. Welcome
back. You can't figure out there, Lucas.
Lucas
is
Lucas.
Lucas. Okay. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
The tech expert. Welcome again. How many people have not been to the previous lectures in this series? I saw some new faces. Okay. There's a couple of sign-up sheets on tablets and on clipboards, especially the people who haven't been to the other programs. We'd appreciate it if you would sign up with your contact information so we could send you email notices about upcoming events. If you haven't been here to other programs, you may not have picked up a new program guide for this academic year with the other programs that are coming up, so you should for sure pick up one of these. They're around, I know they're on the glass cases out in the hallway area there, and they'll tell you about the next program, which is Thursday evening in this series, the last of the Irish series. It's going to be Thursday evening at the Lucent Public Library up in Callahan Hall on the third floor. So those of you who are dedicated Irish, what do they call them? Irish files?
Hiberno files.
Hiberno files?
Hiberno files.
Hiberno files. Anyway, those of you who have been so dedicated to this, we appreciate it. I'm sure you'll want to go to the next one. And then in October is the next program, which I mentioned last time, is going to be in the Garcelon Cemetery on a Saturday afternoon. So that's listed in here too, and you'll see that notice in the papers and around, hopefully. So everybody who's been here before to the other lectures in the series know John Henderson, everybody else probably does also, but I'll tell you what I normally say about John. We know that he's Irish. We know that he grew up here in Auburn and then traveled around because he grew up in a military family. He graduated from the Maine Maritime Academy in Castine, from USM in Portland, or Gorham, either one, or both.
Thank you.
And when he got older or more mature, as I like to say, he came back and at the same time got interested in his Irish roots, and that's generated all this curiosity and research, writing the book and preparing the lectures. So, I know that you will welcome him as I do in adding this segment about the professions of the Irish people in Lewiston and Auburn. John.
Well, thank you, Annette. Welcome again, and thank you all for coming out again tonight. Fourth of the five-part series, and tonight we're going to talk a little bit about the professions, different ways that the Irish people in our community contributed through their work. We'll talk a little bit about politics and a little bit about the social organizations, and just to fill some of the other topics out a little bit with the details of individual lives. This is what I found fun and interesting as I got into my own family's project. I'd gotten the genealogy done and then started trying to fill in with, well, okay, so what, now that I know that they were born, married, and died, What else did they, what did they do in between? And, you know, with a bit of research began to uncover, as I said before, this massive community. And so we'll look at some of those things. And again, I stress that what I'm presenting tonight and in all of these programs and in the book, it's an introduction. That's all it is. I don't claim to know everything there is to know about the Irish, because there's so much more yet to discover and document. So this is an overview. There are undoubtedly lots of folks that we won't talk about tonight and Thursday that are stories out there waiting to be found. And tonight, class, we're going to start off with a quiz. And we might have enough for everybody, but if you can pair up, actually, and or pairs or triplets, to see what you can do here. It's a building identification exercise. We've looked at a fair number of slides. Maybe just take a couple of minutes to look through, and if you've got a pen, jot down the ones that you remember. Okay. How are we doing? Okay, on the first page, the first one, does anybody know? Yes, it's the Androscoggin map, as it looks today. Okay, and the second one? Batesville, correct. And the third one? Yes, exactly. The Linelli or Bonnelli block. Very good. Next one down. Yeah, that's the central block. Central. It's at the corner of Lisbon and Main Street. It's where Dosti Jewelers is today. How about the fifth one down?
McGillicuddy block?
Yes. First McGillicuddy.
First.
Yeah, first McGillicuddy. Yeah. That's at the corner of Lisbon
Subway
and Ash Street.
Yeah, Subway.
Yes, it has the Subway Street. Yeah.
Okay.
And the sixth one. Lincoln State Tree Patch. Yes, Gas House Patch.
Yes. Gas House.
And the next one down. Clifford House, right? Yeah. Clifford House, right? Yeah. And the one on the bottom.
Wallace School. St. Patrick's Wallace School.
No.
No.
No. It's the Bleachery, it is. Lewiston Bleachery and Dye Works. And that one wasn't very sporting of me. I don't think we've shown that one yet. Didn't see it tonight. Okay, on the back of the first page, at the top.
Back of the first page.
City Building, Lewiston City Building. Yep. And the one below it?
The Machine Works on West Bates.
Yep, it's the Machine Works, Lewiston Machine Works. That's your landmark for where the shingle patch used to be, right?
Is that where the...
Just up the street from there. Yeah, not far from there.
No, the D across from Memphis.
And the third one down.
No clues.
Okay, that's another one that wasn't very sporting. We'll see that one on Thursday night. This is the second Callahan block.
Mm-hmm.
On Lisbon, it's on Lisbon Street, just past Chestnut Street.
Way down.
Yeah, it's well down the street, yeah. And the fourth one.
Condon, St. Joseph Condon?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is it just Sisters of Mercy, Joe?
Sisters of Mercy, yeah, correct, yeah.
What's this one?
Sisters of Mercy.
St. Joseph.
And the one below. Yeah, Sisters of Notre Dame, very good. It's over at St. Patrick Church, yeah. And what church is depicted? St. Joseph's, yes, one steeple, one spire.
St. Joseph's.
And the one on the bottom, St. Patrick's. And top of the third page. Yep, St. Patrick's Rectory.
St. Joseph's Rectory.
Okay, so we have St. Patrick's Rectory, and below St. Patrick's Rectory, St. Joseph's Rectory, yep. And below the rectory? St. Joseph's School, the new school.
Oh, the new school.
Relatively new school, yeah. Not new anymore, but relatively new. And below St. Joseph's School. Wallace School or St. Patrick's School, yeah.
H Street.
Yeah, it does look similar in this picture. It does look similar to the Dingley Building. Yeah.
So it is Wallace.
It is the St. Patrick's School or the Wallace Building. Wallace School. Building. Yeah.
I know what that is.
It's
right. And below the St. Patrick's School. It's another block on Lisbon Street. Yep. It's the Union Block. And we'll talk about that more on Thursday. Yep. And I know the folks in front got the next one.
Willow Patch.
Yeah, it's the Burnt Woods. Yep, well, Willow Street, the Willow Street. Willow Circle. Yep, sorry, thank you. Willow Street. Woods, yeah. Now it's Adams, yep. So it's, yeah, Willow Circle or Burnt Woods, and extra bonus points if you put number 9.
That's the Monsignor.
Yep, and the next one down is Mount Hope.
Mount Hope and Monsignor Wallace.
Mount Hope, and then the one at the bottom is the Roque Block. Just check. I'm wondering if I'm going to have to guide you home tonight.
I think I got one.
And top of the page on the back.
Top of the page on the back.
Yes, Jacob Roque House. Very good.
Where's that?
That's over in Auburn on Elm Street. Do you know where the Women's Literary Union is?
Yes.
Yeah, it's right across, directly across the street.
And that's the Jacob Roque House.
Say again?
Oh, yeah.
I haven't found that, but I wouldn't be surprised. Yeah, it was Jacob Roque's house. Yeah. And below Jacob Roque's house, not St. Joseph's School. Yeah, the Phoenix Block.
Where is that?
The Phoenix Block is in Auburn on Main Street. It's where Gritty McDuff's is. That's where Jacob Roque was the president of two banks at the same time in the same place.
Two banks.
You got that?
Canal. Yes, and then the easy ones.
Bill 5.
Yes, Bill 5 is on the right. Yeah, if it were in color, you would know that it was the focus is on the canal. Yeah. But it's black and white. I can't tell. Yep.
I know what it is.
Yeah, there you go. Below the canal is Denny Sullivan's store.
Denny Sullivan.
Yeah, Denny Sullivan. Short for, or nickname for Dennis. Yep.